happened to be sharing with you this morning, see for breakfast, or this afternoon, see for brunch. It comes to us today from Grace Lee Boggs. Grace Lee Boggs is an activist, writer, and speaker. Her work as an activist has encompassed every major United States social movement over the last 100 years. Yeah. Boggs has been awarded a number of honors, including honorary doctorates and lifetime achievement awards. Her Building a Movement to Grow Our Souls speech was given at the Bioneers Conference, an annual conference with a environmental focus in Traverse City in 2004. Over the last 6 years, I've had the enormous privilege of participating in most of the great humanizing movements of the second half of the last century. Labor, civil rights, Black power, women's, Asian American, environmental justice, anti-war, each was a tremendously transformative experience, expanding my understanding of what it means to be an American and a human being, and challenging me to keep deepening my thinking about how to bring about radical social change. However, I cannot recall any previous period when the issues were so basic, so interconnected, and so demanding of everyone living in this country, regardless of race, ethnicity, class, gender, age, or national origin. What is going to motivate us to start caring for our biosphere instead of us using our mastery of technology to increase the volume and speed at which we are making our planet uninhabitable for species and eventually for ourselves? Where will we get the imagination, the courage, and the determination to reconceptualize the meaning and purpose of work in a society that is becoming increasingly jobless? How are we going to redefine education so that 30 to 50% of inner city children do not drop out of school, thus ensuring that large numbers will end up in prison? Is it enough to call education not incarceration? Or does one top-down education system created 100 years ago to prepare an immigrant population for factory work bear a large part of the responsibility for the escalation in incarceration? How are we going to build in a 21st century America in which people of all races and ethnicities live together in harmony, and Euro-Americans in particular embrace their new role as one among many minorities constituting the new multi-ethnic majority? And especially since 9/11, how are we to achieve reconciliation with two-thirds of the world that increasingly resents our economic, military, and cultural domination? Can we accept their anger as a challenge rather than a threat? Out of our new vulnerability, can we recognize that our safety now depends on our loving and caring for peoples of the world as we care and love for our own families? Or can we conceive our security only in terms of the patriotic act and exercising more formidable military power? We live at a very dangerous time because these questions are no longer abstractions. Our lives, the lives of our children and future generations, and even the survival of the planet depends on our willingness to transform ourselves into active planetary and global citizens who, as Martin Luther King Jr. puts it, develop an overriding loyalty to mankind as a whole in order to perceive the best in their individual society. So, it is not only idealism, but realism that calls upon us to seize this opportunity to engage Americans in widespread and wide-ranging conversation to explore the ideas of Dr. King to help us redefine what it means to be an American in the 21st century. Thank you.